Appreciate it. You know what I mean? Daniel, thanks for bringing Millennial London to the Marvel Universe in this movie.
Yeah.
Big steppers.
Come on, you know how it goes.
Come on. my brother, talk about the scripting because it was on point. That was that was one of the things that most impressed me from this.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, bro. Like, it was, they were just open to, like, they wanted to be real. I think, like, Kemp had spent some time, you know, the play One Night in Miami? Mm-hmm. He wrote that. He spent some time in London doing that play with Don Martin. He's just like, yo, he was like a black British guy. Daddy, he was just like, it was amazing. He said, Daniel, bring that, do that, whatever's real. I was like, you sure? He said, yeah. I was like, some words you may not understand like that. He's like, no, just, we'll make. But it shows that their obsession with authenticity mm-hmm. and detail, like, no matter what world they're in, they're like, what's the real in that world? Mm-hmm. And they're kind of just like, Daniel, just say, what would you say? In a real world, what would you say from London? So that's what I really wanted, is like the character to feel like real London, connect with it, but also there's a bit of like Cockney rhyming slang, there's a bit of punk in there, there's like that melting pot that, you know what I mean, London
I like,
is.
No, I love the way you conflated, you know, that whole intelligent with the anti-establishment, with the road man. It was something you hadn't been seen before, especially in this context.
Mm-hmm.
I appreciate you for bringing that.
No, love.
A little bit of context on the backstory for Spiderpunk. As succinctly as you can, because we ain't got all day, but it's a bit hazy, so help people anchor the story a little.
Basically, he's from like a new London, which is a mixture of New York, but it's like a new London, and he's from like a really oppressive place where if you're a hero, you're a punk person. Do you know what I mean? And so it's kind of like George Orwell 1984, like hyper oppression, hyper surveillance. And he just comes from that reality.